Hello everyone and welcome back to another video. It is Francesco here from the Keep Productive YouTube channel. On today's video, we're doing something a little bit different. I'm going to be sharing with you today my weekly review, how I go about doing it with the tools that I use currently, the process that I use currently, and giving you a bit of an outline of how you could implement something like this. Now, I've been using a weekly review for maybe about 3 years, and I've really benefited from it from a work perspective in terms of pausing on one day of the week for maybe 20 to 30 minutes to grab a bit of time to reflect on the previous week, but also plan the next week ahead. And on today's video, I want to outline how I go through that process. So guys, that's going to be on today's video. So I have taken my desk away from this area to set up this area just because I want to show you guys step by step how I go through doing the weekly review. It's taken a few years to get to this stage in terms of what it is today. So I've had a lot of different iterations of it, and I tend to change the way I do a weekly review maybe every 6 months because I don't want to have to keep chopping and changing what it looks like in terms of a framework. So guys, what I'm going to be doing is showing you a screen share of my laptop as we go through it, and I'm also going to be showing you what I do on paper too. So hopefully that gives you a bit of an outline of everything you need to know. If you want as well, in the description below, this will be available to have a little look at in terms of a step-by-step process. So if you want to go there as well, that'll be helpful. So the first thing I want to talk about is the sort of situation or the scenario of the weekly review. And I find it a good time to stop and pause, look at the week ahead and plan it. It also gives me an opportunity to look at my goals for the upcoming next month or so and help me to orientate all of my tasks, my next 30 days of actionable tasks towards those goals. I also get to look at clients that I'm working with in terms of my day role as a freelancer, and I get to see exactly whether I need to put more time into my clients or make sure that I'm on track with all of those projects. So it's not only a good way for me to look at my own goals, but a way for me to look at the client goals and where I'm currently at with all of those. So in terms of a scenario, I typically do this at home, although I have done it in a coffee shop maybe every 2 to 3 weeks. Weirdly, when I'm at home is go on the ground and do this. And when I mean ground, I mean the floor. And I'll just bring my laptop, a piece of paper, and I tend to put my phone away. I try to put it in another room, unless it's relevant to me sort of plotting anything out. Now, I typically do this on a Thursday afternoon. Normally, it's about like 3 or 4 o'clock, and it's normally after like my driving lesson or something like that. And normally, Thursdays are a bit of my sort of more meeting-y day, so I am actually more engaged than I am normally. Today is a Thursday, and in today's video, we're actually going to be doing my weekly review for this week, so you'll get an idea of what it looks like practically. So I'm actually going to plan and plot everything out. So this is my process, and I'm always looking for ways to improve it. So if you have any like tips or recommendations in the comments to maybe fine tune a certain area of it, please do recommend. And also, if you want to share your own setup or process, that will be amazing too. I think the comments will serve as notes as well. So guys, I've broken this down to a 6-part process, so hopefully it can give you all you know. And then afterwards, we'll talk about the sort of micro habits or techniques that I'll go about within those certain things. So the first thing I do is start with paper. Now, the reason I start with paper is because across my week, I tend to be using a lot of digital tools, and paper does help me just to plot out everything. It also helps me to add in things and remove them and quickly, like, I don't know, there's something about paper that helps me to avoid distractions, especially when I'm planning the week ahead. Now, typically I'll do it on a bit of A4 paper. I previously used the Baron Fig Week Pad, which is a great one, but I also have an A3 sketch pad, which is a perfect canvas for plotting everything out. So it doesn't matter the size of your paper, although the bigger the better, because if you're making mistakes or you're moving stuff around, the more space, the better it is, and the less cluttered it will look. So today we're gonna start with the A3 piece of paper. So let's jump over to this. I feel like I should go, here's one I made earlier. Okay, so what I typically do here is I'll title it Week Review. And what I'll start doing is tallying out the next 7 days. So the next 7 days for me are Friday and Wednesday. And that's my idea of a week ahead, because I've got everything until next Thursday. So this is a good way to be able to do that. So as you can see, I've got a rough outline. I've got Friday, Saturday, Sunday, Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday. And what I'll do now is I've got the next 7 days. So I'm going to start giving a line underneath all of these at the bottom. Now, the main thing here that I'll note is that tasks belong here and events belong here. So anything in this region here will be task orientated, and anything in this region just below will be event orientated. So what I'll do is I'll open up Google Calendar on my computer. So because it's span across the next 7 days, I need to look at obviously tomorrow, Saturday, Sunday, and go to the next week view to see anything there. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna add any of my Google Calendar events into the likes of this piece of paper. So let's add a few of those for the upcoming week. So as you can see here, I've added the bulk of the events down here. And the reason why I do events first is because they almost dictate the energy levels for the tasks. So for example, if I'm looking to plan some of my tasks for the day, at least I know these events are here so that I don't clash them. Because a lot of my work, you'll see on Todoist a bit later, is time orientated. So what I'll do next is I'll open Notion. I'll specifically open the goals page inside of Notion. And what I'll begin to do is I'll start adding a few of the goals and specific tasks that I can do next week that help me to complete those goals for the next month ahead. Now, this is a really simple thing to do, but it does help me to orientate a lot of my tasks next week to the actual goal side of stuff. So let's take my first goal, for example, is reaching with the Keep Productive blog is reach 10,000 monthly unique visitors. So what I'm going to do is I'm gonna start plotting a few of the tasks that orientate some of the goals here onto my tasks area of the paper. So as you can imagine, I'll begin to add those goals to this area. Okay, so now that I've had a general plot out of some of my main bulk goals for the end of the month, I will then start to do some of my basic tasks. And this will be based on two factors, is the things that I need to do in terms of just like general things like activities, like, I don't know, pick up new passport or buy indoor plant, all of those sort of small items. And then what I'll do is I'll add in client-based items. In order to do this, what I need to do is open up my clients page inside of Notion and start extracting activities per client of what I need to do for the week. And then I'll plot them out in these next 7 day view. So what I'll also do is I'll open my Todoist account and I will look at the next 7 days, because across the week, I've probably snowballed a lot of tasks into that next week. And I need to get a general outline of what other projects I'm working on to be able to plot them into the next 7 days on this piece of paper. Okay, so I've got a general outline of my tasks that are upcoming and also my events. Now, the good thing here is what I can start to do is start to cull any of the tasks inside of my Todoist account that are unnecessary anymore. This way, it helps me to really define and get rid of some of the older tasks that I've added in and also refine what I'm actually going to be doing that day. So we started number one with some paper. We plotted out the next 7 days of events first, and then what we did is we opened up goals inside of Notion. Now what we did is we extracted the goals and the tasks orientated to those goals into the task sections of the paper. We then went over to the clients area of Notion, extracted any project-based information, and added any additional tasks from the likes of Todoist and also from my head. So now what we've got is we've got a piece of paper full of the tasks that I want to do next week, as well as a recap of the events that I've got on. So that typically takes me around about 12 to 15 minutes, something like this. It doesn't take me a huge amount of time, But I do spend about 2 or 3 minutes just pausing and thinking about if there's anything time orientated or project orientated that I do need to do inside of this that I may not have updated inside of clients in Notion or goals in Notion too. It also gives me a little bit of time to reflect on the week that's just gone. Was I productive? Do I need to do anything better? And I can also add in any habits or routines as well that I can improve. So now is where the bulk of the actual actions and administration goes. It's inside of Todoist. So what I will do is I'll open up my Todoist account and I will begin to subtract all of the tasks over the next 7 days and put them inside of inbox with no due date. This gives me a clear runway to add all of the brand new tasks inside of Todoist and help me plan the week ahead. Now you're probably wondering, this sounds a bit laborious, but actually the act of taking tasks down here, almost recycling them or recreating them in a different format actually helps me to plan the weekend really well. Same with events, actually taking them down from Google Calendar and putting them here in event section actually reminds me that I'll be going to them and also helps me to boost my energy levels during that day. For example, if I had lots of meetings on a Thursday or a Tuesday, then I know that I'm going to be doing more shorter based tasks versus long, intense focused tasks because I'll have less time to do so in between those meetings. So let's dive onto Todoist. I'm actually just gonna be working on Todoist for this one so you can get an outline of how I go about plotting that out. I wanna also then talk about a few techniques near the end and give you a few other outlines. I'll just get my glasses for myself. One thing I'll add here as well is the actual process of adding all of these tasks to the inbox really does help me rethink about the actual actionability is that word, and the actionable nature of the tasks, as well as giving me an idea of whether I actually need to do this one. And it helps me to be a bit more refined about my time. So that's just something that I'll note as well there. Okay, so just another note on this, at the weekend, I'll occasionally do some bits of work, whether that's like an hour here or there. Becca normally watches like I'm a Celebrity, which is a popular UK program, so I will grab a bit of time to do work then, because I really hate I'm a Celebrity. Okay, so there we go. Okay, so I've pretty much added the majority of tasks into Todoist. Now what I'll do is I'll do two very small things. I will go back up to inbox and I will drag in any tasks that I see relevant. If not, if I don't see any of them relevant, I will archive the majority of the ones I've replicated or moved into Todoist. Now there is another simple way I could have done this, is I could have kept all of the tasks in inbox and then just gone to inbox and plotted them out. But in this case, I had a lot of different type of tasks in this activity. Now the other thing that I will do as well is I'll go to the task list that I created. A task list is all of my different small tasks that I want to do, low priority tasks that I could maybe weave into this week ahead. Now I then finalize by going over to filter, plan, highlight, and what I will do is I will go down the list. In this case, I actually should go to the next 7 days and just pick one most important task to complete during the day. And this will help me focus in on what I need to get done during that day. Okay, so I'll go to plan highlight and I can see the most important tasks over the next couple of days. And these are the tasks that I need to complete and they're almost must activities. So there you have it. That's my full week planned. I've got everything in events that I've organized. I know what events are coming up. I know what goals I'm working on. I know what is coming up in my next 30 days of actionable tasks. And anything else is small administration work. Now I just want to run through the full process and give you a few bonus things that I may not have mentioned at the start of this video. The first thing we did is we got some paper in front of us, some A3 paper, and we plotted out the next 7 days. We added a section for events, a section for tasks. We then went to Google Calendar and added the events from Google Calendar for next week into this piece of paper in front of us. We then went over to Notion, we opened up the goals section of Notion, and we plotted out the most important tasks or tasks that are related to the goals that I can complete next week. Then what we did is we opened up clients' side of Notion, as well as anything in the task list in Notion. So then what we did is we opened up clients inside of Notion, and we also looked at any tasks that were in my head and also inside of the next 7 days in Todoist that I can now add inside of this section. Things that I do on a routine basis, but also things that relate to some other projects outside of client work. And then finally, with everything in front of me, I then plotted that all out inside of Todoist. So guys, that's my process. I'd really love to hear your weekly review. Let me know in the comments whether this video was useful, because I've never done a video like this before, and it'd be great to hear whether you found it valuable and whether it's something that in the future you'll be looking to implement. Anyway guys, a big thank you for stopping by today. I hope you enjoyed this video. Let me know in the comments below how you found it. Feel free to like this video if you enjoyed it. If you are brand new to this channel, do subscribe, and thank you very much from me. I will see you guys in the next video. Cheers.